is focused on debunking myths and exposing lesser known facts about the cannabis industry called Weed Between the Lines. So I need two audience volunteers who will compete to win a mini financial coaching session from Bravely. You don't have to know anything. They're really simple questions. We're tight for time. Come on up here, two people. Yay!
My name's Griffin.
Griffin, nice to meet you. And tell everyone your name for the audience. I know who you are, but tell everyone.
Sarah.
Sarah. So Griffin and Sarah, we're going to compete. Let's get into it. So you'll just write the letter of what answer you think it is, and we'll get into it. Okay. Of the 8.2 million marijuana arrests between 2001 and 2010, 88% were for what charges? A, selling marijuana. B, buying marijuana. C, having marijuana, or D, your Aunt Carol saying, I'm so bad after one hit of a vape pen at a Brandy Carlisle. Of the 8.2 million marijuana arrests between 2001 and 2010, 88% were for what charges? A, selling marijuana, B, buying marijuana, C, having marijuana, or D, your Aunt Carol saying, I'm so bad after one hit of a vape pen at a Brandy Carlisle concert. What do you guys think it is?
Yep.
So Griffin thinks C. Yep, you both are right. It's simply having marijuana is most arrests. How much money has been invested in school construction as a result of marijuana tax revenue in Colorado? A, 40 million, B, 3.5 million, C, 1 billion, or D, real talk, my Catholic school didn't have enough books to go around. Meanwhile, our priest was driving a Ferrari and embezzling money. How much money has been invested in school construction from marijuana tax revenue in Colorado? A, 40 million, B, 3.5 million, C, 1 billion, or D, my priest was embezzling money in Catholic school. What do you guys think? A, 40 million? Hey, oh my God, you guys are tying. I hate you. More questions, and I don't have a tiebreaker. Okay. The USDA considers marijuana a Schedule 1 drug and claims it lacks medical value despite its proven effectiveness to alleviate symptoms among those with cancer, AIDS, glaucoma, and is often an alternative to synthetic painkillers. Which of the below is not a Schedule 1 drug along with marijuana? A, heroin, B, ecstasy, C, cocaine, or D, HEB chocolate hummus? Yes, I know it sounds gross and my Syrian ancestors are rolling over in their grave, but it's good as hell with fruit. Don't knock it till you try it. So what is not a Schedule 1 drug? A, heroin, B, ecstasy, C, cocaine, or D, HEB chocolate hummus? I don't even know at this point. B, ecstasy. C, oh, you guys are really sucking and you're still tied.
Damn it.
It was obviously HB Juggernaut. Okay, last question. I mean, it could be, I don't know. HB's got everything. Every state that has legalized medical or recreational marijuana bans people with drug felonies from working at, owning, investing in, or sitting on the board of a cannabis business. But as I mentioned earlier, black people are 4 times more likely to be arrested for marijuana charges than white people, despite equal usage. Which means, after being screwed over by the government's war on drugs, black Americans are now largely missing out on the economic opportunities created by legalization. This is A, effed up, B, really effed up, C, really, really effed up, D, Jeff Sessions up, or E, all of the above. What do you guys think it is?
Solid E.
C, all of the, E, all of the,
D?
C and E? Okay, you guys are tied, so we're gonna do rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Like an even number of questions. All right, let's do real quick. It's best out of one because we're cutting our time.
One, two, three, shoot.
Yeah, one, two, three, shoot.
One, two, three, shoot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Get a free financial coaching session. And you also have a real Lisa Frank puzzle in there and minion stickers because they look high. Sarah, you also win something. You win the knockoff Dollar Tree version of Lisa Frank.
Look at the world differently.
vagina eraser. That was